Morning, guys. I won't lie, literally only woke up at 9:30. I'm glad I wrote the workout last night, because I just couldn't get up today. I'm shattered. Absolutely shattered. Right, I think this kind of weather doesn't help. I don't know what the weather's like where you guys, where everybody is, but here it's just kind of still a wee bit hot, but it's rainy and grey. So today we are going to train back, and that'll wake me up anyway. I'll definitely get a long band, and this sports bra is from Hera. It was the company that Sandra Pricker used to own. I don't think it exists anymore. There was some sort of weird lawsuit thing that happened. They all fell out, her and Jeremy Buendia. Drama. It might still exist, but it's called Hera. It's got matching leggings as well. Shorts are for rider wear. They don't match. So we've got a long band and definitely a short band. I'm going to use a few of these wee jobbies. I think these are about £6 from a company called HXE. I'll tag them in a post. If you've not got any bands at all, these are already, which most people have, these are quite useful just because they've got wee handles, and they come in nice colours. There's a nice blue one, a purple one as well. Right, so back. Let's just warm up the back first, and then we'll just steam in. Right. Just do as I do. Hands on the shoulders, I'm going to stand up. Roll. Keep doing that, I'm just going to fix this. Keep rolling the shoulders, make big circles with the elbows. That's it. Both hands up. And take them forward. And we take them back. Okay, feet, shoulder width apart, small bend in the legs, hands up, and we're just going to twist. Try and keep your hips facing the ground. And you are literally just going to let them smack off you, right? Same thing, just nice big loose twist. This always feels a bit weird. Feels like something you'd do when you were about 5 in the playground. And coming back to centre, feet shoulder width apart. We're going to take a side bend, so hand goes up. Don't kick this hip out, keep your hips straight. And pull it in. Other side, keep your hips straight. Don't let that happen. And pull it in. Come to the floor. We want to mobilise the back, so on all fours, knees, hands, same distance apart. We're going to drop the head and tuck the pelvis under. Give your back a big stretch. Then head comes up, bum comes up. And breathe into that stretch as well. Other way, pop it out, head falls down, bum tucks under. And reverse. Other way, Amanda. And last time, head up, bum up. Okay, we are going to do a quick couple of floor stretches before we start this. So you're going to pull back, feet together, knees apart, and just stretch your hands way out in front of you. And then we're going to walk these hands to the left while you push down on the right hip. So walk your hands to the left, push into the right hip. Make sure you're pushing your bum back. You get a big stretch up the side here. And back to center. Other side, same thing. Walk your hands to the right. Make sure you are still pushing down actively on the left butt cheek. Good. And flip round on your back. Right, so we're here. And my feet are pretty close to my bum. I'm going to stretch my hands across the floor. And then I'm going to cross my right leg over left. And I'm going to drop my knees to the right. Trying to keep the opposite shoulder on the floor and look in that direction. You should get a big stretch through the spine, through the lower back, through the upper back, through the entire back actually. And then come back to center, opposite way. Top leg is the direction that you drop in. And keep the opposing shoulder on the floor. Look along the line of that hand. And bring it back in. Okay, let's begin. So, grab all your bands. And I'll show you what round one is going to be. Right, so get a seated regular row, which will probably be with your long band. Now, if you've got a curved back in this, bend your knees or sit on something, right? Because the only way we're getting this to hit our backs effectively is with good form. So what I mean by that is when you are in this, right, we're going to sit on our bum for the first exercise. See if your lower back's like that, rounded, no good. So we need to be upright, okay? Kind of like you're locked into a machine. If you need to bend your legs to be upright, that's totally fine. And we're going to row, thinking that we're bringing the elbows together and that we're trying to squeeze the scapula shut, okay? So just keep thinking that you're trying to get your elbows to touch each other. That's my dinosaur impression, my T-Rex. So we're basically doing a T-Rex, right? You can go double band if you want high tension on that, which I would recommend because back's a big muscle and we're not using heavy weight here. Then we're going for an overhead lat pull down. So with your short band or your long band doubled up, right? I'm going to use one of my newbie groovy bands. That's where these are cool with the handles. You pull apart, Now we're thinking about being on a lat pull down machine, right? And this is where I see people making an arse out all the time. When you're on a lat pull down, your hands can't possibly come down at the side of your ears, and you'd fuck yourself in the face with the bar, right? So think about the bar path of a lat pull down. You are actually slightly leaning back and you come in front of your face. Right, remember that. That's what's going to actually get the lats. If you're trying to do something right beside your face, you're probably not hitting them. Then we're going to go for, pull apart gliders. Again, you can use your band doubled up. I'm going to use my newbie nifty bad boys. Put our hands in and we're going to pull apart, right? Now, see, as soon as I pull apart there, I kept the shoulders down. Depress the shoulders. So this should be eating into your back delts. And what we're going to do, which seems like nothing, but believe me, if you're pulling apart, it is going to seem like something pretty damn quick, is just move up and down, right? That's it. But you must be pulling apart. So, dead easy. Let's get involved in that. You need to sit your bum on something for the seated row. Go for it. That's totally fine. Turn the music up. Let's get some good tunes on and let's get stuck into it. Woo! That's an anabolic move. Sometimes I just like a move. It gets me going. Right. So, get your back up nice and straight. Boobs out. Chest up. Put your feet. Right. Regular row. Try to get your elbows to touch each other. Here we go. Squeeze. Squeeze. Good. Keep breathing. We're breathing. And we're squeezing. That's us, 20 deep. We've got 30 to go. Keep the chest up. Keep your form good. Make sure you are squeezing your shoulder blades together. Halfway. When do we go around squeezing what lats? Probably never. But after this session, if you get yourself in a mirror and just, I won't date with both because that's quite, probably a bit boobs, but you can actually squeeze it. I can feel it coming in and inserting all the way to here if I squeeze it properly. That's what we need. We need that squeeze to make this work without any weights. Right? So again, we're squeezing. We're breathing. Let's go. Pull apart. Squeeze. Come on. Just imagine you're on a machine at the gym. Provide that tension. Come on. Don't cheat yourself. Chest up to meet the bar. Technically the band. Keep your elbows in line with each other. We're almost there. Keep pulling it apart. Come on. Don't cheat. 10 to go. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. Relax. Oh, I actually love how this coordinates with my outfit. I'm really not that much of a girly girl, but sometimes I geek out a bit. Right, so we are now going to get into these pull aparts. Now, what I want you to think about and remember here, if anybody's done this, if you never try it when we're finished, right? But see, when I was a kid, this is bizarre. It might sound bizarre. You would stand in the door frame, right? And you do that with your arms and you force them out as much as you could. And then when you walked away from the door, your arms would float up. Did anybody do that? See, if you never, you need to try it. Honestly, it's such a strange feeling. And that's the type of tension that I want you to bring into this. So we are constantly forcing apart. These, Gemma, these bands are good. They're not really, really strong. So I would definitely buy two if you was going to get them. That's much better tension for us, I'd say. However, right now I'm just going to use one because this next move is fucking hard. So we're providing that constant tension, a half inch there in the door frame, you're pushing out, but your palms are facing in. And we are literally just going to get through this range of movement here. Bring it up, we keep the shoulders pressed down, and bring it down with complete tension. So bring it up, and when you come up, I don't want your ears to be tickling your delts, right? Make sure there is space, make sure we can see that you've got a neck. Right, let's do it. Get in position! And hulk out. Up we go. Down. Keep it slow and controlled. Magic fingers. Thought I was giving the magic fingers there. Keep that tension. We'll put that tension. We're doing fuck all. Yes. Keep forcing away. As much as you can. I love a burning wee bastard. That's what this becomes. You know that feeling when you go, oh, why have I chose to do this exercise? Keep going. Come on. If we're working, we might as well fucking work. Shoulders a roll. We're going to get you round two of moves. Okay. Right. We're going for some rollouts. So these are primarily actually to, I suppose, stretch some of the lower back before we work into it. Loads of people get issues with the lower back, myself included. My heart really tightens up, especially when I'm teaching posing or teaching lies like these. So I keep my legs bent as I roll down. It just allows me to actually get some of the stretch into my back and my hamstrings. So when you're rolling down, I want you to think that you are curving from the top up. Right, so the chin comes in, then you're rolling to the top. Each individual vertebrae on the way down, so don't just fold in half for me. It's called a roll down for a reason. So we roll down, we walk forwards, we come back, we reach up, right? I keep pulling these fucking shots. I started dieting. And I've lost a couple of kilos since last week. I know I don't look it yet, but usually takes a bit of time to show. But these shots are just sliding about now. Right, so we're going to roll down, roll out, roll back, roll up. We're just going to get through that a few times, mainly for mobility reasons. Then we're going to go into standing bent over row wide. Okay. So we'll go single arm. No, time-wise, no, we'll go double arm, right? So you're going to get inside your band, and when we were sitting down, we did that this way and tried to pull the elbows together. This time, we're doing it like you're a T-shape. So we're coming from the front, but we need to be bent over or it's going to get your shoulders. And we're pulling up like that, right? Like you're one of the wee dancers. Just keep that in mind. So nice flat back. Don't give me a big curve in your back like that. Just keep a flat, neutral spine. we're here and we pull up, right? Like a wee scarecrow. And then we're going to get into, now this isn't the name, I just love to make up names. And I think my names are much better, much prettier than the norm. So we're going to get into mermaid tails. So we're going to get the lower back. We're going to lie on the floor, face down. If you're pregnant, please do not lie on the floor face down. All right, we don't want to squash your woman insides. Don't do this if you're pregnant, right? You can do it standing up, single leg. Now, we're trying to work the actual lower back here and not the butt cheek. So we need to try and take the butt cheek out of the equation, because it, and that's why we lie fully on the floor. So we're here, right? And I'm going to put my feet together. So I'm thinking about it as a tail already. Squeeze the quads, squeeze butt cheeks, push the tops of my feet into the floor. I'm going to put my head fully down and then I'm just going to raise my feet up. But when my head's down, you should get your lower back more. So we're here and we're going to go mermaid. So I can feel the majority of my legs coming off the floor, and I do feel it in my glute, but I feel it in my lower back. So ideally, if you keep in mind that we're trying to pull through the lower back, that should be the primary mover and the glute will be the secondary, okay? So keep in mind lower back. Now, let's get stuck into this. I'm not going on this song to go back. We're going fast, roll down, walk out, roll back, and up. Woo! Here we go! Roll down, walk out, back, up. Come on, keep it coming! Woo! Keep going! Good, good gin, Max. Right, that's it, it's getting hard now. So 10 to go. 10, 9, 8. Love how I said that 9 like a horse. 9. 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax. Right, we're going to get into these lower back. Tails, mermaid flex. Remember, I want your lower back to be the prime mover. So try and keep your mind connected to your spina erecti, okay? Which are the two muscles that just go up the side of your spine at the bottom of your back. Oh, let's go. Okay, everything engaged. Squeeze. Get your head on the floor. You can make a wee bed with your hands for it if you like. And we're going to lift. Mermaids everywhere, right? 5, 6, 7, 8. Lift and down. Lift and down. Lift and down. Lift and down. God, this hurts your vagina. Lift and down. Lift and down. Lift. Oh, down. Lift. Down, lift, down, lift, down, lift, down, lift, down, 5 to go, 5, 4, down, 3, down, I apologise if you had to do that on a wooden floor there. That was brutal. Let me get a wee pillow. That's that lesson learned. Next time we do any mermaids, we need a pillow. Like if you're a guy doing this, I thoroughly apologise because that would have totally mashed your bits. You just tuck that right through to the back. Well, that was not pleasant, but definitely got the lower back. So that's a bonus. Right, now, last round. I know that we are really wooden floor fanny squashed. Indeed, especially if you're not carrying a lot of body fat, just now that would have been brutal. That was noted. Right. So we're going to go into the single arm stuff now. I've ran over time. I just love it. So I apologise for taking up more of your day than I should. But we'll do this and then I'll let you guys stretch off yourself. So see the stretches that we did at the beginning? Just run them again. Please make sure you stretch, right? We're tightening all the bits of your back right now. Tightening them all up. Right? Taking the muscles to their shortest point. You need to stretch that out. Otherwise, something in your back will probably spasm, and when a muscle in the back spasms, it's always so much worse than anything else going. So lift down. I know what the voice is brutal, isn't it? Like I always forget when people. I'd say that I'm quite heavily Scottish. So I come from a council estate. Middle class, and that's where the voice comes from. People have said to me when they've met me and they knew my name, they expect me to be Spanish, and then this voice comes out. I think it's terrifying. It's definitely terrifying to some folk, which I don't mind. It's the no bullshit voice. Right, so we're going for a single arm lat pull down. We've done this before. Remember what I said about the lat pull down earlier, right? If you are in a gym, you're not pulling at the side of your head because you just hit yourself in the face. So the hand is slightly in front of your face. You can see the hand and the elbow is definitely in front of the shoulder. And you need to squeeze that lat again. So one hand's a stabiliser. I'm going to use this wee dude again. I'm quite enjoying these today. Right, so one hand goes up, it's a stabiliser. you grab your band. And see how my band's coming in front of my face? Because my hand's in front of my face. Right? Remember what I'm saying about getting it in front of your face. Otherwise, we'll not hit your lap. And then we're going for a rear delt single arm. So how I like to do this, because I see people doing it with bad form, it's a small movement, right? It's like, it's literally the tiniest movement so that you can keep your form good. What we do, we'll use this long band because I presume that's what most of you have. We're going to hook the opposite foot for the arm that we're going to work. Now I do this on the gym, do this in the gym on the cables like this. What I'd say about it is just make sure your leggings aren't see-through because it is quite a bend over, right? So you're doing this in the gym on the cables, make sure leggings are fully enforced at the butt. Come over, right? I'm going to put my elbow on my knee in this hand here, and that is to make sure that I don't twist around the corner because that's not the point. So we're here, we're down, and look at the size of the movement. I'm trying to work this wee tiny muscle back here. I don't know, I need to get leaner so you guys can see this getting hard, but that's the plan. Right, so that's the move. That's how bent over I am, and that's what I want you guys to do. Now, after that, we're going to go for a move that I like to call the Morton J, right? Don't judge me. That's probably not its name. You guys know me by now, I like to make things up. There are two different versions of this that will hit two different things. In this version, we're going for the rear delt again and some of the back surrounding the rear delt. So, I want you to pretend that you've got a bow and arrow, and you're going to shoot me, right? And we're going to pull, I'll show you with the band in a minute, we're going to pull back to our face here, back to our cheek, right? So you've got your band, I'm going to use this one. You've got your band here, right? Elbows up, and we pull back towards the face. But see how I'm not trying to twist my body back? So keep facing the front, just trying to pull your elbow round the corner, but keep it high. So that is going to take your rear delt into a tight position, and you're probably going to feel it down the side of the scapula as well. So let's run these bad boys. Sorry, I don't know your name because it's came up McInnes, and I presume that that's not your first name, because that would be very unusual, but look who's talking. My name's Margarita, and that's unusual. So, McInnes 1978, I put these ones on my YouTube channel. They just go straight on there. So there's, I think there's about 10 on there already. So even though I've been doing these for 11 weeks now, never started putting them on YouTube until Instagram took off the feature where you could leave them running. So they'll be on my YouTube. There's quite a few up there if you want to try them. Banter varies. Some days I'm writing about it. Some days I'm fucked. But, you know, the exercises are always there. Right. Let's get into this. So, single lat pull down. Here we go. Coming up. One hand's the stabiliser. And get your distance. Remember your elbow's coming slightly in front of you. Here we go. One, pull. Come on, engage that lat. Remember how I showed you earlier? Needs to be squeezed to make this work. Don't kid yourself on with the tension. So if you heel like this, honestly, don't be shy. Grab it higher. As I say, we're spending the time anyway. So we might as well put the work in. Five to go. And bring it down. Keep your hands where they are. Other side, because the distance is going to be roughly the same. Pull down. Keep this shoulder away from your ear. Right, I don't want you bracing your arm on your head. That's an injury waiting to happen. Engage the lat. elbow in front of you. Come on, keep pulling. Five to go. Five, four, three, two, one. Relax. We're going to take that straight into the delts. Bend over, right? That is the key here. Bend over, brace your hand here. We are doing a small move. We're not trying to get away around the corner. This is not about flexibility. Opposite hand from foot. Bend over. Get yourself set up. Elbow to knee, hand to knee. Keep your face, keep your shoulders facing the floor. Grab your band quite low. Here we go. One, not a big movement. Keep breathing and squeezing. Don't be tempted to twist. It's not about your body, it's about your shoulder. Your rear delts are on your back. That's why we're working them. And switch to the other side. Exact same thing. Stay bent over. I know it seems weird, but you know, you get used to it. Elbow to knee. Hand to knee on the other side. Keep your chest facing the floor. Pull. Small movement. Not a big grand movement. Keep breathing. Five to go. And relax. We're going to take that into the bow and arrow. Remember what I've said to you. Keep the elbow high. Right, and bring your hand to your cheek. Don't try and twist your body around. Just try and pull your elbow back as much as it'll come back. Get in position. First hand comes forward. Now you'll need to have a look at the tension on this for yourself so you're actually getting a decent pull back. Right, so my hands are that far apart so that when I pull back and stretch, I'm getting a good one. Right, so the last move, best move. Let's hit it. Get in position, elbow up. This hand's going to come to your face. This arm's straight. Here we go. Pull. Two. You're in the Hunger Games. You're Katniss Everdeen. You are shooting cunts left, right, and centre. Woo! Keep the elbow up. Don't twist the body. Think about it being your back making the movement. Last one. Right. Other side, exact same thing. You're going to bring this hand to your cheek. Straighten your front arm out. I've not changed my distance. And pulling back. Breathe. Last five, come on. And relax, that's it. All the other districts are done in. If you've not watched that movie, you won't get the reference, but it is on Netflix. It is worth a watch. What the hell is it? I thought I felt something in my hair there. Right, so I'm going to let you guys stretch out yourself because I need to go and walk the dogs, and I ran over here about 10 minutes and they'll be sitting down in the living room farting away, and you get down there and it just smells like a farty party. It's absolutely terrible. So enjoy your Thursday. I'll be back here on Saturday on this page. I think it's legs, but like I said, all of these go onto my YouTube channel forever, so you can run them whenever you fancy a wee bum workout, there's one there. You fancy a wee chest workout, there's one there. Yeah, and they're all different. So I try very much never to do the exact same workout twice. So yes, I'll see you on Saturday, and enjoy the rest of your day. And thank you guys for joining me.